Well, it's an absolutely exciting day in Wellington today with the launch of The Hobbit. I think it's just brilliant that the world premiere is here on our doorstep. And before you ask, no, I'm not walking the red carpet. I'm not going to the world premiere. But I'm kind of jealous about our ministers that are going to be there for the big occasion tonight. And I think to put some perspective around it, we need to just actually reflect on what this means for New Zealand. There's been a lot of publicity around the fact that we've supported the film industry, and if you look at just this movie alone, it's meant 3,000 jobs, and so into the local economy as well as the New Zealand economy, it's been fantastic. I have to say, in the northern part of the electorate, there's been a large number of people who are coming in and of course heading to Matamata, which is not far from Cambridge, to see Hobbiton. And the feedback I've had from people who've been visiting recently just say that Matamata is just looking absolutely stunning. So it's great for the Waikato region as well. And I think probably the even bigger picture that we need to focus on is the fact that when these movies are made, they're made here in New Zealand. Anyone who watches those movies, all of a sudden we have the potential for more people who are keen to visit New Zealand, if they're Hobbit fans or not, because they see the landscape, they see the environment in which these movies are made. And if that changes their mind in terms of making a decision to have their next holiday or the holiday after here in New Zealand, well, we all benefit. Tourism is a significant part of New Zealand's economy. And so to have films made here and to have New Zealand promoted as a place to visit is just fantastic. So if you're a Hobbit fan, you'll be watching avidly over the next few hours, and of course getting along to the movie whenever you can. We've just come back from a recess last week, and it was a fairly full-on recess for a number of reasons. I had a number of ministers visiting the electorate. One was Minister Paula Bennett, and she came to speak at the National Federation of Budget Services Conference, and I spoke there the night before she did. And then she spoke at a white paper for vulnerable children meeting that we held, and we had nearly 60 people attending, a wide range of people from across the social services sector, as well as representatives from health and education. And I've also had white paper meetings now in Cambridge, and I held one with Alfred Narrell, our Cook Island MP in Tokoroa. I've had a really good response, and have actually had people say afterwards they found out after the fact and would have loved to have been there. So I'll actually look at holding some more meetings in the new year, because it's really important that people understand what our plan is for better protecting vulnerable children. And as I've said previously, this is not just something that the government can do, it's something that communities and families and individuals have a significant part in. So I'm really keen to give you the opportunity to hear about what we're doing and to also learn about how you can participate in helping us protect our most vulnerable kids. Then I had Kate Wilkinson, who's the Minister of Conservation in Taupo, originally to come for the opening of the Ohaaki Wetlands. And it's just a fantastic project just outside Taupo, on the road towards Rotorua. And it's a wetlands project that has been initiated, well, the idea came up about 30 years ago, but actually it's been under construction for the last 6 years. And it's fantastic to see local farmers, local iwi, Department of Conservation and Contact Energy, who have put most of the funding in. So it's great to be able to see a project like this that's culminated from so many hours of hard work and effort. And I'd really encourage you when you get the chance to go and have a look and just see some of the bird life that are inhabiting the wetlands. It was quite opportune that the Minister of Conservation was in the electorate, because of course after the rumblings at Mount Tongariro on Wednesday, we had a visit down to Turangi, met with the community leaders, with iwi, with DOC, with GNS, and just got an update on what's happening. I was somewhat frustrated when the activity happened again, because some of the media reporting just blew it entirely out of proportion, which I get annoyed about, because yes, it's an active volcano, it's always been active, there's been more activity recently since the middle of August. But in reality, the area that's at risk is quite small, And so some of, well, Tongariro Crossing has been closed for obvious reasons because of the need to protect public safety. There will be sections of that opening up again. But the vast majority of the Tongariro National Park is open and has always been open. And so it's important that we get the context right in terms of, yes, there is activity, but it always has been an active volcano, so people need to be aware of that at all times. But we don't want anyone to get the message that that part of the Central Plateau is closed for business, because absolutely it's not. And it's quite interesting because, if anything, the murmurings on the mountain, the volcanic activity, is actually increasing the level of interest with the mountain, and of course with Ruhepehu next door, it's had some activity as well. And as long as people are well informed about what's happening, we've got the best science and information from both GNS and DOC to be able to manage the risks and be aware of what's happening and have a plan around and a proper response to that. So we'll keep watching what's happening there, but it was great that Minister Kate Wilkinson was able to get a briefing and be there on the spot last Friday. So we're now into a few more weeks of our sitting before the Parliament lifts. So there's this week and two more. It's fair to say that at the end of year, no matter what business you're in, whether you're in Parliament, whether you're in schools, there's always this kind of end of year rush in terms of wanting to get a whole series of things completed and ticked off. So it does feel a bit like that here in Parliament at the moment, but we will get there. And I appreciate you tuning in today. We'll give you more information on the white paper meetings in the new year. And just keep following on Facebook. I do encourage, if there's any particular question that you want me to answer in these video diaries, put it on Facebook, post it for me, because I'm really keen to make sure that these video chats with you are answering the sorts of things or providing the sorts of information you're interested in. So don't be shy in asking me a question, and I'll catch up with you next week.